We formed a quorum and it's also the appointed time. I call the meeting to order. Let's start the election of the chairman at once. We have 9 candidates and they're already on the screen here. Last time, there were 2 suggestions for how the election forum should be run. And I think most members are inclined to go for forum B. Can we have it projected out? The 2 options are, in fact, very similar. If there is no objection, let's go for option B. Any objection, please? All right, no objection. Then we go for forum B. I mean, option B. We'll start our election forum. Each candidate will be given 2 minutes to tell us his platform. Give me the list, please. The first is Dr. Priscilla Leung. Thank you, Chair. If after chance to continue to be the chairman of the panel, I would like to follow up my issues of concern to the sector. First, insufficient manpower for the judiciary, education, and also prospect for graduates, and also issues related to the Occupy movement and social unrest, whether they have undermined the rule of law. And there was also arson of the electrical building. And I think we should uphold the rule of law and we should ensure that the judiciary... quiet, please. Please go on. Thank you, Chairman. Please return 2 seconds to me. I can give you 3 because I can't complete it. I think the chair would agree that arson to the High Court is a blow to the rule of law and is going to ruin Hong Kong as well. And I ensure the meetings are conducted in an orderly manner. I also encourage laymen of law to have an opportunity to express their views. Now, we usually have 2 or 3 members are discussing in this panel, and they were mostly from the legal sector. But in recent years, we have seen more lay members joining the panel. I would hope to have their contribution as much as possible. Take the PMP issue. If we could set up, if we could discuss it there, we would have no need to set up a subcommittee under PMP. You need another 3 seconds to respond to the concern of Mr. Ray Chen. He referred to our records. I did a survey, and most members are of the view that there is no need to, because most members of the security panel didn't want a joint meeting, and that's why we end up having none. Mr. Ray Chen, I joined this race because I'm very unhappy with the chairman of the last session, because she made it impossible for this panel to have a public hearing on the Fugitive Offenders Bill. Now, Mr. Chang can made a very good point. First, the chairman can make a ruling, and if many members disagree with the chairman, then there should be a vote. And I think the chairman cannot shirk her responsibility to a so-called survey. And Priscilla Leung, another candidate, that setting fire outside the court would destroy the rule of law. Well, I think even if the hardware is damaged, that doesn't mean that the rule of law is damaged. And we don't know who was the culprit. Perhaps somebody was unhappy with the court's ruling that the anti-facial covering regulation was unconstitutional. Nobody knows. Now, if I were the chairman of this panel, I will follow up a matter of issues, including LLC report on sex offenses, which is very controversial, and also the sex recognition review committee chaired by the SJ. She has yet to hand in her homework. And also the LLC is also working on legislation regarding cyber crimes. I think we should have a joint meeting with the security panel to deal with all these issues. Whoever gets to be the chairman, he or she should pressurize the S4J because we're all not happy with her performance. Mr. Ted Hui.
Thank you, Chairman. If I were the chairman of the panel, I would urge the SJ to attend our meetings. I think the AJLS panel was among was one of the panels where attendance from the SJ or secretary was the lowest. And then she, even if she came, she just read out from a script. So if I became the chairman, I would urge the SJ to improve. And if I were the chairman, I would be more lenient in allowing motions without notice. In previous meetings, I wanted to move a movement, a motion to censure the S4J, and then I was ordered to be removed by you, Priscilla Leung. And we've also had given a joint letter on an investigation into those anonymous dead bodies found, and I would give it top priority if I became the chairman.
Mr. Jeremy Tam, I joined this election because of the issues arising from the Fugitive Offenders Ordinance. I had the SJ been more prudent, things might not have happened. And many members criticize her for not attending meetings. Perhaps she doesn't have the freedom to attend meetings because she doesn't even have the freedom to resign. There were rumors that she was sent from the UK to PLC and back to Hong Kong. So though she wanted to resign, she was not allowed to do so. Of course, that was reported by the Financial Times. I hope what was reported was not true. But if it were, I now understand how come she could not attend our meetings. Perhaps she was sent to Lama Island or elsewhere and cannot get to Queensway. If I became the chairman, I would ensure that SJ would not be subject to any intimidation or be sent to the mainland for a medical treatment. I will for sure give her a hand. So if I became the chairman, I would make sure, or I would do my utmost to ensure the SJ can attend our meetings here to show the world that we still have freedom in Hong Kong. At least she has her personal liberty. And because it was reported that she didn't enjoy the right to resign, and if she cannot ensure her personal liberty, how can she safeguard that of Hong Kong? And now I begin to understand how come her performance was so bad.
Ms. Tanya Chen, one candidate, Priscilla Leung, said that if we had this AJLS meeting before the motion moved by Mr. Dennis Kwok would not have to be debated in council. If I remember correctly, the motion was not carried. So I hope that Priscilla Leung can follow up on that, because SJ has made repeated blunders in making declarations, starting on the first day she resumed office. So if we stock tick on her behalf, I think she would be grateful. And another member said that setting fire to the court would be damaging the rule of law. Well, we have 24 members in this council lodging, criticizing the anti-facial regulation, anti-facial covering regulation. And I hope the SG can tell us whether she can deal with the people who challenge the rule of law in Hong Kong. And because of the recent judicial review, it's likely that we may have the sixth reinterpretation of the basic law by the MPCSC. SJ should explain to us. Well, there have been interpretation of the basic law as well as local legislation. This has gone beyond what's allowed in the basic law. This is a fatal blow to the rule of law and independence of a judiciary in Hong Kong. And then LRC has got issues for us to follow up, like class action and cyber crimes, etc. I'd like to know how the other candidates are going to follow up on that. Mr. Gary Chen, now if I were elected, I would chair meetings in a fair and just manner. And the reason why I joined this race is to compete with BPA, Priscilla Leung of BPA, because the way she conducted meetings were not satisfactory. And we have serious political and social crisis in Hong Kong. Now, if demonstrators have broken the law, that's a matter of law and order. But if the police have broken our laws, that is really disrespect for the spirit of the rule of law in Hong Kong. So far, the loyalists, including Priscilla Leung from BPA, are still supporting the police blindly, and this is a disrespect for the rule of law. They are not defending the rule of law as representatives of the people. Priscilla Leung would only stick to the letter of the law, and I think this is a wrong understanding. I think we should use our laws to serve as checks and balances of the executive, and then we should do our duty to ensure that such things will not happen. We've seen too many cases when CE used the judiciary to suppress people with different political views, and even in the prosecution process, double standard was observed. We have to follow up on these issues. So that's the reason why I want to join the contest. Dr. Fernando Zhang is not here. Dr. Joseph Lee. I am a layman in law, chairman. The reason why I want to join the election is I have been touched and moved by SJ. As someone from the medical sector, I'd like to know how come SJ could wear turtleneck even though her wrist has been injured. I have been lecturing nursing for 20, 30 years, and I have yet to see someone with a broken wrist to put on a turtleneck sweater. So maybe the SJ has abused our legal loopholes, and as a chairman, I must put this item on the agenda.
The
administration is acting like a rascal, a shameless rascal. If the Secretary for Justice is so seriously injured and yet she could wear a turtleneck sweater, well, I have worked in this profession for 40 years, and if she is really abusing the loopholes in the law, I will study them here. Is it that we are doing some harm to the spirit of the rule of law? I think we need to face squarely up to this. This will be one of the important missions of the chairman, but the S4J wanted to resign, but she failed to do so. And of course, if the S4J would go, I would resign from this competition. If not, I would want to be the chairman so I could study into the case of the S4J breaking her wrist and wearing a turtleneck sweater, or else we'll be harming the rule of law. Dr. K.K. Kwok. Presiding officer, the biggest problem we are facing is that there are no rules and no regulations. One country, two systems today has been totally wiped out. I'd like to assist Dr. Priscilla Leung with one thing, though. I remember at a meeting, she said that she was not a slave. She did not have to listen to a master. I don't want her to be a slave. We must find someone who does not want to be a slave to be the chairman of this panel. So that person would not look like twins with Theresa Jiang, which would do further harm to the rule of law. We are witnessing a judicial disaster. In the past 6 months, over 6,000 people were arrested. Since the DOJ is now a department to mount political prosecutions, we see a lot of youngsters arbitrarily taken to court. This is a serious problem. They have given a lot to Hong Kong. If this is allowed to continue, if we see the rule of law in Hong Kong being eroded more and more, I am very worried. The quality of prosecutions is low. They are mainly political prosecutions. Therefore, this panel is an important panel. We should not act like an echo of the government. We should not be minions. We must protect the rule of law. I hope you will support Pan Democratic members becoming chairman. Okay, second segment. Members can ask questions. Each one will have 1 minute. Can you switch off your mobile phone? Ms. Tanya Chen, chairman. Don't know whether you would consider this because at 2:30, we will attend the House Committee meeting today. As you know, Mr. Andrew Leung always has this consideration. He would like to preserve the integrity of a debate or a discussion. And, well, yes, I also have to chair the meeting at 2:30. That's correct. We should finish this meeting early. Do you have a different view? Maybe next time we can receive questions from members. Ms. Claudia Mo, then Mr. Ray Chan, then Ms. Anne Chang. Ms. Claudia Mo. Thank you, Chair. I find this a little strange. I'm not the chairman or deputy chairman of any other panel. I thought I would be nominated, and then I could say I would accept nomination. Just now, why did you not call my name? The clerk is Ms. Claudia Mo nominated. And aren't I in the nomination list? No, you have not been nominated. Oh, too bad. There was this misunderstanding. Mr. Ray Chan. Chairman, you said just now that you would like to adjourn this meeting. And then a member shouted out to say why. I'd like to... Well, you used a louder voice than she. Well, okay. Now, 50 members at most can raise questions, but we only have like 8 to 10 minutes. And then if we ask Dr. Priscilla Leung questions, then she can prepare her answers using a week or so. I think that is unfair. I agree with Ms. Tanya Chen that we take up this segment next time for the sake of totality. Okay, next, Ms. Anne Chang, chairman. Whether we can complete a discussion in one meeting, well, everything is in disarray now. You have been the presiding officer to elect the chairman and deputy chairman for many times. I thank you for your hard work and your precious time. But it's okay. Let us look forward. We don't know when we can elect the chairman and deputy chairman. 2019 is going to bid farewell to us, and 2020 is coming on. And if you look at the outstanding items, there are many things that are of concern and should be discussed, like the judicial service pay adjustment. And if these are not discussed by the panel, we cannot submit them to the Finance Committee. And also opportunities and challenges for young legal practitioners in professional development. We need to discuss that. Young lawyers would like to have more opportunities for development. We need to carry on with such urgent work. Shall we not process more quickly and boost efficiency? Well, we know you are barristers and lawyers, and you might want to clock more time so you can have a bigger bill. Well, but this does not apply here, right? So can you consider quicken the process? Well, that's what I'm trying to do. Then let us just put it to a vote. Right? Mr. Lam Chuk Ting, Chairman. I heard Ms. Chang accusing you of being a legal professional. You are trying to clock more time in order to cheat more income. I think that is insulting to your legal profession. It is a serious insult. Sorry, members not coming through. Sorry, members not coming through. Now let's ask Ms. N. Chang. You said he was trying to clock more time. What do you mean? You mean that means that they are trying to get more payment. Is that right? That's as simple as that. If you don't know that, you are really shameless. You, DAB. We cannot carry on with the meeting if you continue to shout among yourselves. Ms. Ann Chang, that was my time. But you have finished, Ms. Chang. You finished and it was my turn. The president asked you not to shout. Mr. Junius Ho, please do not shout from your seat. There is only 5 minutes left. It's impossible for us to complete the question session. I adjourn the meeting until next time.